been in love. You could touch the moonlight when your heart is shooting stars. You're holding heaven in your arms. Have you ever been so in love? Ever walked on air? Ever felt like you were dreaming when you never thought it could, but it really feels that good? Have you ever been so in love? Have you ever?
Ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, beloved ones, please stand for the entrance of the bride.
to me.
Good afternoon. I am Reverend Judy Ann Davis Young. It is my honor to preside over the wedding of Geraldine and Willie. Thank you for being their guests. Thank you for taking the time to be here. And on behalf of Geraldine and Willie, it is my honor to say welcome and thank you. We are blessed by your presence. Please silence your cell phones and any other electronic devices. So collectively, we can honor this sacred occasion. Please do not live stream this ceremony. This is a sacred occasion. Placing this on Facebook minimizes the sacredness of it. And this is for those who are physically present. Those with cell phones, please be seated. You may take your pictures from a seated position. But let everyone have the pleasure of not being obstructed by your photography. Who presents this woman for marriage?
I do.
Thank you. Let us go within and begin this ceremony in prayer. So join us in prayer. Allow these words to be in your words as we anchor this moment before God. Taking a deep collective breath, I just say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, divine, glorified God. Thank you for your presence and your anointing and your appointing. Thank you for the opportunity to be here to preside over the wedding of two beloved friends. Thank you for all the family and friends that have traveled near and far to witness, acknowledge, celebrate, and be present for this exchange of pure love. They are blessed that there are over 7 billion people on this planet, and they have found each other. Love never gets old and it never dies. It is forever blooming and the hearts of the young at heart. We just say, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing to thine ear. We are your children and in whom we want you to be well pleased. As these two saints come before you, we just say, thank you, Jesus. And together we say, and so it is. Amen. Amen. Words of commitment. Geraldine and Willie have come here today to make public their love for each other, to honor their truth, to declare their choice to live and partner and grow together, to speak out loud and be witnessed by your presence. Their desire is that you will come to feel a very real and intimate part of their decision to join in marriage, and with your love, make their love even more powerful. They have come to be joined in marriage. They have also come here today in the hope that their declaration of love will help bring us all closer together. And if you are here with the one you love. Let this ceremony be but a reminder, a rededication of your own loving bond. Love is such an amazing gift in this life, more powerful and gentler than any other force in the universe. It takes us to depths that we could not imagine. It brings us joy that nothing else can, and challenges us as nothing else will. When I asked Willie what he loved most about Geraldine, he said, "She's the right one." I'm going to say Jerry, because when I say Geraldine, that's foreign because we've never called her that. So do you mind if I call you Jerry? Thank you. He said, "She is the woman I love. It was a no-brainer. She enhances all that I am." And he said, "She may not know it, but she inspires me." And that's something we should always do for the one that we love. Be an inspiration. When I asked Jerry what she loved most about Willie, she said, "He loves me, and I love him." She couldn't imagine her life without him. She accepts Willie, and he accepts her. And may they, for as long as they live, that he is the compassion to her passion. He is patient. He is kind. And he has impeccable integrity. He loves her just the way she is. Surely love is a gift from God. In John 4:16, it says, "God is love, and all who live in God or live in love live in God, and God lives in them." Today we can agree that God is in Jerry and God is in Willie, for their souls reflect the pure essence of love between a man and a woman. 1 Corinthians says, "Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be still. Where there is knowledge, it will pass. Love always wins." Today, you enter into this marriage happily and also thoughtfully, longing to deepen your understanding of love's mystery as well as love's ecstasy. The mystery as you strive for your individual goals and yet share your dreams. The love that you each are forever expanding and deepening. As love beings, we've come to know that with that expanding and deepening will inevitably come change. The ecstasy as you express your unique talents and still share a common life purpose. We remind ourselves today that while marriage symbolizes the intimate sharing of your two lives, that sharing does not diminish, but enhances the precious and awesome being that you each are individually. A good marriage is one which allows for change and growth in each person and in the ways that love is expressed and demonstrated. To this moment, Jerry and Willie bring fullness of their hearts as a treasure to share with one another and with us. The two of you bring the dreams that bind you together. You bring that particular personality and spirit which is uniquely your own and out of which has grown the reality of your life together. Khalil Gibran, the great prophet, said, "Let there be space in your togetherness, and let the winds of the heaven dance between you. Love one another, but make not a bond of love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Sing and dance together and be joyous, but let each of you be alone. Give your hearts, but not into each other's safekeeping. for only the hand of life can contain your hearts and stand together, yet not too near together. For the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress grow not in each other's shadow. Love possesses not, nor would it be possessed, for love is sufficient unto love. Jerry, please hand your bouquet to Geraldine. Standing facing each other. Jerry, will you please extend your hands out, palm up. Willie, place your hands on top. Geraldine, I want you to look at Willie's hands as if you're seeing them for the first time. These are the hands of the man that you are choosing to marry. These are the hands of your best friend. These hands are strong and vibrant with love. These hands holding yours on your wedding day promise to passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future, as you laugh and cry, as you share your innermost secrets and dreams. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will comfort you in illness and hold you when fear or grief engulfs your heart. These are the hands that, when wrinkled in age, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. These are the hands that will tenderly lift your chin and brush your cheek as they raise your face to look into his eyes, eyes that are filled with completely with his overwhelming love and desire for you. Willie, please turn your hands palm up, and Jerry, place your hands on top of Willie's. Willie, looking through the lace gloves, look at these hands. These are the hands of your best friend, smooth, manicured, and carefree. They're holding your hands on this wedding day as she promises to passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will massage the tension from your neck and back in the evening after you've both had a long day. These are the hands that will hold you tight as you struggle through difficult times. These are the hands that will comfort you when you are sick, or console you when you are grieving. These are the hands that, when wrinkled in age, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. These are the hands that will give you support as she encourages you to chase down your dreams. Together as a team, everything you desire for can be realized. Love seeks to always express itself in truth and faithfulness. Love is patient, and love is always kind. Love looks for the best in each of you, believes the best of each of you. Love never fails. And when the story of your life is told, I hope that your love defines the greatest accomplishment in human relationships, and that is a marriage. May these hands be blessed that we see before us this day. May they always be held by one another. May they have the strength to hold on during the storm of stress and the darkness of disillusionment. May they remain tender and gentle as they nurture each other and their wondrous love. May these hands continue to build a relationship founded in love. I'm going to ask you now to turn a loose of this hand and face your family and your friends. Surely you notice you are not alone in this place. You come with your family and friends. Your life together has already been filled with love, gentleness, laughter, and joy. Today, we not only celebrate the continued life you will build together, but we honor the family that you have already become. Today, we make this family official. Are you two ready to be official?
Yes.
Oh, I think they're ready. Finally, Geraldine and Willie, is it your belief, and you may turn and face each other, is it your belief that marriage is about providing opportunities rather than producing obligations? Opportunities for growth, for full self-expression, for lifting your lives to their highest potential, for healing every false thought or small idea you have ever had about yourself, and for the ultimate reunion with God through the communion of your two souls. That this is truly a holy communion, a journey through life with the one you love as an equal partner, sharing equally both the authority and the responsibilities inherent in any partnership, bearing equally what burdens there be, basking equally in the glories. Is that the vision you wish to enter into this evening? If so, say it is.
It is.
Now we are going to exchange the wedding rings. Can I have the rings, please? All right. The act of giving and receiving rings reminds us that love itself is an act of giving and receiving. You know, the early Egyptians can be credited with the customary wedding band. They believed a circle was the symbol of eternity, a sign that life, happiness, and love have no beginning and no end. They saw the ring as a symbol of holiness, perfection, and peace. A wedding ring was placed on the third finger of the left hand because they believed there was a vein that ran from that third finger directly to the heart. Today, these rings represent an inward belief and trust in togetherness. They express an outward sign of commitment. Geraldine and Willie, now I ask all of you to join in the blessing of these rings with the belief that these symbols of their marriage will be made stronger as our voices rise in unity. You are sharing this sacred ritual because of the bond you all share with them. And in blessing their symbols of love for each other, you are helping to make their commitment stronger. So please join me with this prayer and repeat after me. Wake up. Blessed Holy Spirit of love and life.
Blessed Holy Spirit, love and life.
Out of this whole world.
Out of this whole world.
These two souls have found each other.
These two souls have found each other.
Their destinies shall now be woven.
Their destinies shall now be woven.
Into one design.
Into one design.
Their joy and their perils.
Their joy and their perils.
Shall not be known apart.
Shall not be known apart.
May your home be a place of happiness.
May your home be a place of happiness.
For all who enter.
For all who enter.
A place for renewal.
Place for renewal.
In each other's company.
In each other's company.
A place for growth.
A place for growth.
And a place for sharing.
And a place for sharing.
A place for music.
A place for music.
And a place for laughter.
And a place for laughter.
And most of all, a place for prayer.
And a place for prayer.
And for peace.
And for peace.
And for love.
And for love.
Amen.
Amen.
So, I'm going to ask Willie to take her ring. As he holds her left hand. And Willie, you're going to repeat after me so that we can hear you with this ring.
With this ring.
It's too late now, baby. You came back out. I take you, Geraldine.
I take you, Geraldine.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My love.
My love.
And my friend.
And my friend.
I pledge to share my life openly with you.
I pledge to share my life openly with you.
To speak the truth to you.
To speak the truth to you.
And with love.
And with love.
I promise to honor and care for you.
I promise to honor and care for you.
And to encourage your fulfillment.
And to encourage your fulfillment.
Through all the changes of our lives.
Through all the changes of our life.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
May my heart be your shelter.
May my heart be your shelter.
And my arms be your home.
And my arms be your home.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
That from this day forward.
From this day forward.
You shall not walk alone.
You shall not walk alone.
Geraldine, do you choose to grant Willie's request that you be his wife? If so, please say, I do.
I do.
I don't think they heard you.
I do.
She said, I do. Geraldine, please take Willie's ring. Willie, yeah, slide it on, honey. There you go. Thank you, and Geraldine, there you go. Now, Geraldine, please repeat after me. With this ring,
I take you, Willie,
to be my husband,
my love,
and my friend.
I pledge to share my life openly with
you, to speak the truth to you. With love.
I promise to honor and care for you.
And to encourage your fulfillment.
Through all the changes of our lives.
With this ring,
I give you my heart.
May my heart be your shelter.
And my arms be your home.
I give you my promise.
That from this day forward.
You shall not walk alone.
Willie, do you choose to grant Geraldine's request that you be her lawful wedded husband? If so, please say, I do.
I do.
I do. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we are moving into the candle lighting ceremony. Our intention today, July the 16th, 2017, we unite our individual flames. In doing so, we notice our unity in no way diminishes or extinguishes our individual light. I am going to ask Geraldine and Christopher to take your candles that you don't have, and someone's going to loan you the candles. And will you hand that bouquet? You're going to step down onto the floor. Geraldine, you're going to go on this side. Geraldine, you're going to walk down. Follow Christopher's lead. You're going to be on this side. They're going to ignite the candles of all of you in the audience. Today we set the intention to fully deepen their love and their relationship with each other, providing greater and greater levels of peace. As the candle is lit, you will pass your flame to the candle beside you, and you will notice that you in no way diminish or lose your light. At this time, our surprise guest artists will sing this song, and I ask that this be done in total silence and in reverence as you look at your candle and realize the love that binds these two together. You only need to light the candle of the first person on the inside aisle. Music, please.
You you're just as sweet as peaches and cream. You must have walked right out of Willie's dream, 'cause you and Willie were meant to be. Fortunate guy, blessed to have Geraldine by your side, 'cause you and Geraldine was meant to be. I thank the Lord for you and Geraldine.
Today, we've set the intention to joyfully deepen your love and your relationship. And as each one of you notice as you pass the flame to the person sitting beside you, it in no way diminished your flame. Sharing your light, igniting someone else's light, inspiring someone else takes absolutely nothing from you. So providing greater and greater levels of peace and safety and love, you each have your individual candle. And this is the last time that you will stand alone. For now you're going to be united and you're going to light the unity candle, symbolizing your oneness. And when you light this candle, you will extinguish and blow out that candle, and you will stand together as husband and wife. When you are ready, please light the candle. Audience members, I ask that at this time you extinguish your candle and realize that the light of God, the truth of God, the brilliance of the divine resides in you. Please let your guiding light that shines remind you today that you are truly as one. So it comes to my favorite part of the ceremony. Today you have been given the holy sacrament of marriage to each other, and God has surely blessed you. your two hearts have declared, and the universe now celebrates you. Inasmuch as you, Geraldine, and you, Willie, have announced the truths that are already written in your hearts and have witnessed the same in the presence of these, your family, your friends, and the living spirit of the one God, by the power vested in me by the state of Nevada, it is my honor, it is my duty, it is my privilege, it is a royal pleasure to pronounce you what you've already declared yourselves to be, husband and wife. You may now salute your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time on recorded history, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Willie and Geraldine Thomas.
Bye.